Anybody starting a low-carb, keto, or carnivore diet should be prepared for the long haul. Don't expect to see final, tangible results for at least 2 to 3 years. Hey there, NJ, Route22.com here with another low-carb, keto, carnivore chat. And this, I've mentioned this several times in the past regarding the long-term goal and framework for your new life. I really think that it takes a lot of experience and trial and error. We talked about information out there and how you need to vet it out and experience your information in action personally over time to really, really make it stick. Like I could write a low carb, carnivore, keto book right now with everything that I know at the moment, and someone can read it and it will not work right away. It's not a magic set of instructions, because even though what I write in that book, if it was written, would be true, people will make the mistakes on their own because they either violate the rules in the book and have to learn the hard way. Wait a minute, you know, I really can't eat sweets because it's gonna screw me up, or I can't eat 3 square meals a day because, you know, at least skipping at least one is good. Like people, you need time to build that data set before you can realize that that one thing is working and one isn't, and isolation and food grouping and all that other stuff. But I really think that low carb should be, you take all the information, you know, I mean, I've been low carb for, it's gonna be a decade soon, and what I knew back in the day pales into comparison to what I know now. And would I have made many of the mistakes I made in the beginning? Probably not. I probably wouldn't have dabbled in gluten-free because another member of my family was gluten-free and we slipped over there. But slipping, I think, is very helpful for most people, because when you slip once, twice, three times, and then you finally get it and you don't slip again. Even if I had all the information, all the correct information in front of me, it doesn't prevent you from slipping. And like, just because it says under no circumstances should you eat this, you'll fall to like natural temptation and violate it. And then once you've felt the pain of really making the mistake, then does it really set in. Words aren't as powerful as experience. And that's why I think anybody who's trying to lose weight, get those stupid quick fix, you know, 30, 90, 60 day plans and expect results in such a short amount of time. Some people, I mean, we lost, I don't know, God knows, 80% of a weight goal in 2 months when we first started. Then you leveled off, then you went back up, and then you went back down again. And it took a long time to not make those mistakes. And to have an unrealistic objective too soon in the game before your body has adjusted truly, mentally and physically, you know, you got to remember these things and remember the pain. And so anybody trying this lifestyle of lowering your blood sugar, lowering your blood sugar, say that 3 times fast, you're going to realize, and you're going to make mistakes. And I think it's good. I think a lot of people go from, you know, vegan to paleo to keto, and they end up going very much closer to the carnivore life, because you have this balance where you get the results you want, but it's not hard to maintain. It's a lot easier in terms of food prep and restrictions. And the most amazing thing is that your hunger literally is under control. You control your hunger quite well. And that's a problem with all the other diets and plans and lifestyles that we've tried, is that the hunger would always somehow creep in there and screw with our plan. And that's it. Take your time, you know, expect to fail. Don't get mad if you fail. Be happy that you have the strength to not fail again in that respect in the future. So that's it. Good luck with your low carb, keto, carnivore goals. And Why don't you go have yourself a nice medium rare juicy burger right now, and no fake meat. Have a good week ahead.